home, and they go in there, and they eventually want to make some CDs. And I don't know much about them, but we'll let them introduce themselves. So we'll just, there's restroom over there that you can use, there's coffee that you can have, so just help yourself. Help yourself. Oh, for a donation, coffee, for a donation. Mel, you don't get it free.
How are you doing, man?
Did you pay for it?
Oh, yes.
I thought I seen.
But I didn't get my change yet.
All right, well, let's pray before we get started. God, we just pray that you would be with the group tonight, and would you somehow move people that they don't just come over here to watch them perform, but that you get the word of God out there and that your heart be moved. And just as they sing, just continue to bless them and be with them throughout the evening. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
They're going to sing for a while, and then after that, we're going to do an offering. And so let's make welcome the Graber family from Grabill, Indiana. Minecraft. Great to be here. And I see a lot of friends out here too, so thanks for coming out and supporting us. I see we got Marv and Mary Beachy here in the front. Thanks for coming out. And my friend Irv Eby here, he's the banjo player. One of the boys forgot their banjo, and I left it up by Clearwater, and so Irv came to our rescue. Thank you. I see I got some my mom's cousins out there, the Graber cousins, out there in a golf cart, so thanks for coming out. Yeah, always good to have support, also to just know that we can all come together for one common cause, and that's to serve the Lord. I know we have friends listening back home. Hopefully the live stream works for us tonight. So thanks to Ed, and give him a hand, to Ed Detweiler, for opening up his place every year for all these fans to come in here. I know it's something he enjoys, but it does take some serious effort to schedule everything.
Yeah.
I'm satisfied with just a cottage below, a little old silver and a little old gold, but in that city where the ransom will shine, I want a gold. Somewhere line up the grandkids on the steps on the open stairway, and we would sing that song. And I had a family, my mom's family was a family of 13, and a lot of you would know some of my uncles, the Grabers there in Grabill, Indiana, and we go by Graber Family Singers. So Chris and Rhoda Graber, I have my family sitting back here, my married children, and I guess I got Chris Allen here in the mandolin, and he is married with a little girl named Jolene, and he does some vocals as well, tenor vocals, and I got James doing some lead and tenor. He's playing a banjo, and James and his wife is from Davis County. James has got two little girls, and we got Nate Kine back here playing on electric, and he lives up north of Grabill in a little town called St. Joe, Indiana. He's originally from Holmes County. Anybody know where that is?
Yeah,
he's a Kine. So he's on the electric back there, and then I've got Joshua on the bass. And Joshua is newly married. His wife is back here with a little baby, a little girl as well. And my daughter, Bethany, last but not least here, she's doing vocals, and she will play guitar on a song or two. Bethany just got married. So she's, how long have you been married now? Where's Trevor? Yeah, so Trevor Hustetler is her new husband. And she's excited. She's living the American dream. She got a little house over in Woodburn, Indiana. Okay. We got a song called Choices. And the song is, it was written by George Jones. And I know it's a song of brokenness, but in his last days, he came to know Jesus and surrendered his life. Even in all the mistakes that he made, it's never too late. First 37 years of my life, that was me. And one day in a horse stall, God changed me. And I have a new perspective of life, and I have a new hope within me. And I want to thank Jesus for that tonight. So we're going to sing a song called Impossible Mile. have my wife's aunts here tonight. Margaret Steery. Margaret, get back here beside Rhoda. I don't know if any of you know the Steeries, but I remember we got married, and my wife said, you need to meet Uncle Furman and Margaret Steery. And they started talking about Florida and how they liked Pinecraft. I had no idea 20 years later, or 30 years later, I guess it is, I'd be down here singing. We have a song called I Believe.
I just read one of his books.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
This is a beautiful song about looking around and seeing the creation that God has created, and to see and believe. I added a verse to this song. I call it my faith verse, so you can listen to it. Song for you called Time. And James on your far right is going to sing this song. And he's got two little girls, and he is starting to think this song has some value. I mean, it always has, you know. But it's just a song until you experience it. And I know many of you, as we sing songs about heaven, it's real to you. And so we're going to sing a song called Time. Tonight. So if it's too loud or not loud enough, why we'll let him take the heat for that. But are we doing okay on sound out there? Everybody hear me okay? You know, we like to mix our harmonies that you can hear the harmonies and not too loud, but I know that, you know, you want to be able to hear us too. So if you have any complaints, come see Kyle right there in the middle. He's right there in the middle of this. So okay, our next song is I Saw the Light. We're gonna do a little bit of I Saw the Light and sing along. Yeah, this pedal back here, I don't know if any of you can see from there, but when you are electric guitar fanatic, why they keep adding to their collection. And it just looks like a freight train headed to Dallas.
Over there.
But he's got all kinds of goods there. I guess JoJo wants to help sing here. This is little Jolene. Sing along with me, though. We'll see if we can get that to happen here in the middle of the deal. Okay, this next song Bethany's going to sing for you called When the Angels Sing. She's going to do one song here, so she just switched on one song, but I think we'll be okay.
You'll be fine.
voice.
Okay. Well, this next song is Take a Little Time for Jesus. Are we all enjoying it tonight yet? The weather's great. What a beautiful night. Yeah, thanks for coming out here and making it a relaxing evening and a time to just praise the Lord.
Amen.
This next song is called Take a Little Time for Jesus. It's an old song that I found. Somebody may know this song. But it talks about drinking that bitter cup. And I was thinking, what is the bitter cup that we must drink? Jesus drank of that bitter cup, and we must drink of that bitter cup. And so I'll study that. Maybe you go home and study that for me. But I know I come up with a few things. I was thinking of myself, giving up self, giving up pride, being willing to be a Christian, to be a follower of Jesus. There's many things that could be a part of that cup. But he drank of that bitter cup. Coming down, and Ed had tonight open. I know there's many other things going on, but I was just excited to see this many come out. But we're from Grabill, Indiana, and I don't know how many of you can speak Swiss. How many of you know how to...
I'm just learning to speak English.
Yeah, my grandmother was a Swartz, and my grandpa, both my granddads were Grabers. And we would be like third or fourth cousins to Davis County, I guess. Somehow or another, there was a Graber in Allen County and a Graber in Davis County. Actually, I think there was five brothers, and they got in a fight. But it wasn't big enough that anybody changed their name. Some of them just moved.
Okay.
Yep. Davis County.
So I guess if you go back 200 years, we're related somehow. But, you know, I have a friend that's over in the Philippines right now, and there's some mission work there, and they sing some of the same songs that we do. Mm. And I was thinking of the song Amazing Grace, and I was just looking at all these different songs. Hey. And I found this old bluegrass song called His Amazing Grace. So here's another version of His Amazing Grace. Thank you.
Amazing Grace. That was my mother's favorite song.
Yeah, we're going to sing one more song. We're going to take a real short break. We're not going to take a long break here tonight. We'll take a short one. And then we'll come right back and sing a few songs. And when I come back, I have a couple of giveaways. We have a leather business, and we sell our products online. So I have some business cards over here. I don't have CDs. I'm sorry. Maybe next year we'll get the Beachies here to help us do some recording. But I do have some business cards over here, and I'm going to give away some key fobs. My daughter's doing leather. She does these leather bags. Like, Rhoda's probably got her sitting out there somewhere. But anyway, we got some of these little key fobs with leather. I'm going to give them away. So I've got a couple quizzes for you here after this song. Or when we come back on.
Trust in the Lord.
Okay, aren't they doing a good job?
Yeah.
I find out he has quite a row of kids, and I find out if you do them two at a time, it adds up pretty fast. He has two sets of twins in the family. So
oh, that's what
he did good. I had to think of that, the bitter cup. If you taste that bitter cup and you keep tasting it, I promise it gets sweet. So just take that and think about that. So now it's time we can bless them. And so if you give a good offering, he's going to give more of them door prizes away. So you might want to dig pretty deep tonight. Who knows? You might get something. So let's pray for the offering. Father, we just pray that you would bless the offering tonight, Lord. Bless the giver, and may you multiply the giving. Just be with each and every one that gives tonight, and that they can take this and use it in the nursing homes or wherever they use it. Or just thank you for what you give tonight. In Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, I can't find where I put my bill. some more coffee?
Yeah, I need some more coffee.
I better not.
Yeah, I better not.
I don't want to sleep tonight.
That's
right. It really does. It hasn't seemed to affect me, though.
Yeah, that coffee was a little strong. That coffee was a little stronger.
Oh, pass it. I thought it was for me.
No.
That coffee was a little bit stronger than I am.
Oh, my God.
I'm not a heavy drinker, I'm just heavy.
Well, I am right there with you. For a long time, I didn't drink coffee at all. I always thought it smelled so good.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
How you doing?
It was over and over again. Yeah.
Okay.
You want to skip twice?
He's kind of nervous, I think. Have you been coming down here a long time?
Well, we started in 2009. Then in 2015, I came down with cancer. And I had chemo. And so that six treatments. And so I tell people I'm in submission.
Submission? Well,
and then my wife, her cancer came back.
I guess with our
with her depression.
Would the people move back there? There's an ambulance coming in for a gentleman in the back there. So if you could just kind of move off the road, we appreciate that.
I had six treatments.
I had colon cancer.
I what?
I had colon cancer.
Oh.
And I got through it. I didn't have to take it.
My young.
I'm not all there anymore.
I know what you mean. I don't have a gallbladder anymore, so I'm not old.
Well, they took quite a bit of my innards out. So.
Well, my youngest brother died from colon cancer. I used to call him my little brother until he started beating me up.
Everybody says a word of prayer right now.
Husband, well, he died,
It was some relation somehow. But I always said tiny boys are big enough to go bear hunt with a switch. Good grief, they've got some big.
Country ramblers.
I don't know.
I heard them the other night. They're good. And I thought, oh, I wonder how.
Well, I was wondering, what did they start? What did they mean? I don't know.
I don't know. Is it just the house or just the outside? Or I was trying to where the world could they be? The pines and pines and Florinda.
Oh, it's where that church is from there.
Oh, the Amish church?
Yeah. They said
I was
across the street.
Oh, across the street.
Yeah, that's what my niece told me.
Yeah.
No, my land, it seems like I bought music down, I guess.
Well, I think I, oh, shoot. I bet there's a line over there. Oh,
yeah. Yeah, I got restaurants.
No, this one here. This one's the only one. I just saw Sam run through here and Missouri and then went over and got caught, said something was riding and they left. They went out there. And that, I don't know if they went home or if they just took some of their
All right, we're going to get back to the music business, so keep this situation in your prayers. And the other thing I want to say, I didn't want to take over Walter's suit, but there was so much going on, and if you didn't get a bucket pass and you want to give, we'll have a bucket up front here. Yeah, if you still want to give for the Graber family. So anyway, and I also have flyers for the upcoming weeks. And today I got another call from a group from Pennsylvania. So it keeps adding on. So anyway, so we'll let them get back to singing.
Okay, we're going to sing Fill Up My Cup with a couple of granddaughters here. They come up, the first time they're going to sing with us here a little bit. So we got Megan, and it's my oldest son's, Loane's daughter, and Olivia. And JoJo wants to sing, but she's not saying her words too clear yet, so I don't know how much she'll sing. But she likes to dance. She loves music. But yeah, let's just take a moment of silence and think about the brevity of life. What God has given us, may we love our neighbor more and may we enjoy life better. I know it was my aunt's husband's brother, I think, Iker, that just went in the ambulance there. And I wanted to say, just take a moment of silence and just pray for that family. You can sing along.
Jesus loved me this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak but he is strong. Fill up my cup, fill up my cup, let it all. Fill up my cup, let
on Instagram. She goes by Grabill Leather Co. You can grab one of her business cards or one of mine up here. But she does these cute little leather, and this is all four colors of her leather bags. I'm going to hold those three up on her. So she's holding three of them up there, little key fobs. So what we're going to do is see the longest married couple out here in the crowd tonight. Is there anybody here married 60 years? No, 50 years. Oh, we got quite a few at 50. Did we have a 60?
Yeah, right here.
Where do we have 60? Right. How about 65? Is there any at 63?
Almost.
62. Okay, 61. Or 62, two of them. Okay, so 63. Any of you at 63? So how many was it 62 years? Okay, two of them. Okay, you're both going to be a winner. So I'm going to take those out there and let them pick one. Let them pick one. Bethany's going to bring them to you. And you put your keys on there, and it smells like leather, and it feels like leather, you're going to like it. And then we're going to take, has anybody here been following us since the first time we came down here?
We got married the same day.
Anybody been following us since the first time we came down here? It's been about 4 years ago. But the lady way in the back, anybody else? But what's your name, ma'am? Stand up. Way in the back. You've been following our singing here since we started singing down here? No?
Yeah.
Did anybody, we come down here 4 years ago. Anybody here at our first concert 4 years ago?
We did.
No? Way over there, there's somebody. Okay. Okay. I think I know that couple. Those are Lonikers from Grabill, Indiana. So she wins this nice black key. What do you call this long one? A lanyard. It's got a fancy name, a lanyard. And it goes to Rudy and Delilah way out there. See your hand up? They're the winners. Thanks for coming out. Rudy and Delilah love music. So if you don't know the Lonikers, go out and see them. They love music. There's a Marla Graber here. She wouldn't be here by chance tonight. Marla Graber. She's probably over listening to the Ramblers. Is Marla here tonight? No? Well, Marla, you just lost your prize. Because she follows us on Facebook and always sends me new songs. So I'm going to, the last one I got left is going to go to Marv and Mary Beachy.
Oh.
So we're going to, they're going to get the last one for being good friends. And he always inspires me that it's not about me, it's about Jesus. That
Amen.
We give him all the glory and honor. Amen. And I appreciate you all. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Last but not least, here's a book. Glenn Graber come up talking about being related. A lot of you know Glenn from Davis County.
Yes.
And a book that he has written, An Amish Boy and a Mother's Prayer.
I just
he
got
said
done with
pass
that.
These books out tonight. So if somebody wants one, there's six of them up here. If you're a Graber or interested in the Graber line, just come right up and grab one of these books.
I just read that.
I'm in the process of it.
So let's. I'm going to change it up here to a song of love. The bracelet that I have on here, I spelled love on a piece of leather because I think it's easy. Jesus said it's easy to love those that love you, but it's not so easy to love someone that that does you wrong. So here, why don't we take a moment in this song and think about the love of Jesus coming down.
Come here.
They come through, they're coming over here. There you go, man. Okay,
take a little more.
Sun shines bright on an April morning, flowers blooming all around, little birds praising praises, it's the love of God coming down. This next song is talking about a personal relationship with Jesus. There's many ways to pray, but the important part is that you talk to him one-on-one. And I know I have my favorite spot to go pray, and I'm sure you do too. But if your prayer life is lacking tonight, just renew your commitment to the Lord to find that spot to go pray. I'm sorry, my voice is off a little bit tonight. I'm just going to have to lower that down a little bit.
Jesus, thank you for each time that you have helped me through. Without your love, I don't know what I do. And thank you for each breath of life, each miracle from you. And thanks for taking time for me when I need someone to talk to.
Here we haven't sang much yet. It's called Love Like Rain. I know Daniel Glick sings that song. I'm not sure who wrote it, but I love this song. That love, we talked about the love of God coming down. And I think that when our heart is open, it's like a rain. It just saturates every crack and crevice and will make you a new man.
Yeah.
How many of you are farmers out here? Understand what a fresh spring rain is like.
Yeah, used to be.
Yeah, you understand that one.
Used to be. When I was a little boy. That was me when I was a boy.
What could he want for someone like me? Empty and broke. Down on my knees.
have Nate do this song. So Nate kind of going to take that microphone there in the end, and he's got a song. It's an old Don Williams song that he likes called "Imagine That." And I looked at that song, and we talked about it. And this is what we see in this song. How many of you? And I know there's some because I have Herb Eby right here in the front row. But how many widows or widowers do we have here tonight? We've got quite a few of you. Okay, my father-in-law, I know I was there, and I was your best friend, and today it's a memory. But we'll share that. We'll share that with you tonight. Nate's going to sing for you.
On Fridays, that's a bunch of widowers from their Dutch.
Well, they do.
And the widowers come on Thursday.
I did know that.
Yeah.
Lonely nights, sleeping alone in an empty bed, in an empty home. Someone to talk to, someone to hold in my arms. Imagine that, how sweet it'd be.
He still made the flight, just barely, but he got on in Detroit and flew. So the Lord has been protecting him, and we're thankful for that.
Amen.
This next song is called "I'm Glad to Know." This was a song that was written by a Hutterite. Does anybody here know a Hutterite? Maybe there's some here tonight. My parents were friends with some Hutterites from South Dakota. You know where South Dakota is?
North, but it's cold.
I remember the first time I talked to him, he said, I said, where are you from? He said, we're from South Dakota and other places.
Can you repeat that one more time?
We're from South Dakota and other places. So, you know, there's a lot of people in a lot of places. And I remember one of these Hutterites from up north sharing her testimony with me. And the way God was working in his heart, I realized there's going to be people from every denomination, every group, every little neighborhood there's someone that knows Jesus, and I'm thankful for that tonight. Do you know him? I'm glad I do. Christ was crucified. Called Why Do We Walk So Blind? It's I think it's written by Nathan Stanley. But the first time I heard this song, I had to weep because you know we're in the midst of a group of church going people. But go to the airport, you know, and you'll find it a little different. Go down into the middle of the city, or look at the movies that's on TV. I was at our Airbnb, and I was trying to figure out what can I watch the grandkids should be able to see, you know. And here's a song called Why Do We Walk So Blind? So if there's love in your heart, share it with that person tomorrow. Why do we walk so blind? Thinking we feeling this way. This next song here, we had a request on a song called When the Wagon Is New. The Graber family, when we were all kids, and it was a big family. I had an Uncle Tom that could sing on the Jericho Road like no other. And the other night, he actually sang it for me again. But we always sang the song When the Wagon Was New. I think it's an old Lewis family song. We'll sing it for you here. I pulled these songs out of a hat, and then Nate and Chris Allen look at me. Where did that song come from? Yeah, Ed said we need to have you home by midnight, so I guess we'll get through the set here. There's an old and rusty wagon that was left to rot away. It's the one the family rode in back in the good old days. People used to gather all around the mountainside, take a look at the brand new wagon and all take a ride. I can still see my daddy songs here for you. This next song is called Farside Banks. Oh. How many of you like that song? Kind of an old-time favorite. Everybody loves this song.
It's not midnight yet.
You got it, sir. Not midnight yet, right.
I believe my steps are growing wearier each day. Still I've got a journey on my mind. Lures of this old world have ceased to make me want to stay. But my one regret is leaving you behind. But if it proves to be his Facebook page, Graber Family Singers. We'd love to have you join. Give us ideas on some of those old songs that need to be pulled out of the hat that maybe haven't been sang for a while. I know I've got about 100 songs in my book, and my main song book, this is what Bethany does. She hides it after I pick my songs for a program because I keep adding songs and changing songs. But I love music, and I love songs with a message, and So that's what we're here for tonight. The next song's about heaven.
Everyone will get along. There will be peace.
Through the garden of my heart, and Irv might be able to help me out in this song, where that song came from, but I think Glenn Mullet sings it, am I right? Walk Through the Garden of My Heart.
They did.
Yeah.
So it's a song that we love, and I want to sing this for you tonight. Sing it for those that are online, wherever you are tonight. Jesus loves you, and in the middle of that storm, keep your eyes on Him.
Amen.
My heart is filled with flowers.
Should have brought my jacket along. I didn't realize I was going to get cold.
Well, I didn't think I needed this, but I thought just in case. I'm glad I did.
I'm going to have Bethany lead this song. My voice kind of cracking up on my lows there. I think you'd rather listen to her sing anyway, right?
Yep.
Right. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, it's your song.
Oh,
blessed you, the garden of your heart. This next song is called Oh Far Country, and I know real estate's worth some money in Pinecraft. I was told that a house sold for $500,000 right here close somewhere.
Pretty close, yeah.
But I'm going to tell you about a piece of property that you can put your name on. You can have the deed and abstract to this piece of property in a far country called heaven.
Dang.
There's a parcel.
And help us do a little bit of the unclouded day. We got to borrow his banjo, and he's probably going to teach James another song between now and midnight. This is the banjo picker right here. Make him welcome Irv Eby. We're going to do a little bit of unclouded day.
He's usually at the jams up north. Irv Eby is, that guy is.
know some Evies.
That's the only one I know.
He's from Michigan.
And the Lord bless you, and hopefully we'll see you again next year. Thanks, Ed, and your friends, you for emceeing, and take care of the evening. Thank you.
Y'all come back.
Y'all come back.
Yeah. All of you.
Yeah. I done got my blesser blessed.
That was pretty good.